Hey guys, it's Kelsey and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe and hit that notifications bell. You can also find me on Instagram at kelsey.ryan. All right, so I am in my last semester of nursing school. I'll actually be graduating this December. So I thought I would share my journey through nursing school with you guys and, you know, kind of talk to you about what it was like for me going through the nursing program and only having one hand. So when I first got accepted into the nursing program at my school, I of course was really excited. I was telling everybody, like, I got into the nursing program, this was such a big deal for me. But in the back of my mind, you know, I was already kind of starting to stress, like, ooh, am I actually going to be able to do some of these nursing skills? My family could even tell you how much I stressed about it. It was something I talked about all the time, like, what if I can't do this? Well, what if I can't do that? What if my instructors don't like me? You know, what if patients don't trust me? All these things, I just thought about all these things constantly. I was pretty stressed about it. But of course, my family always reassured me that, you know, my arm has never stopped me from doing anything in the past. And I've always come up with, you know, little ways of doing things my own way, so I would be able to do it. My first semester of nursing school was fundamentals. So in this class, we learned, you know, basic things like how to clean up a patient properly, how to make a bed with a patient in it, how to do a manual blood pressure, you know, things like that. I didn't have any issues with these skills. The only thing that I found challenging my first semester was putting on sterile gloves. I wasn't really sure how I was going to be able to do that, and my instructors weren't really sure either. So the best thing that we came up with was having somebody with sterile gloves on help me to get my sterile gloves on. And that is exactly what I did when I put my first catheter in that semester. Side note though, I am in my capstone right now and my preceptor actually helped me to come up with a way to put on sterile gloves all by myself. It's really cool. I'm excited that we were able to figure this out. And in a little bit, I'm actually going to be filming a video demonstrating how I do certain nursing skills. So that will be in the video. If you're interested in seeing that, be sure to check that out once I post it. My instructors were really supportive my first semester and they told me, you know, if I ever have any questions, feel free to ask them and they will help me any way that they can. My second semester was not so good. The first day I met my instructor, she took me to the side and said to me that she has never dealt with a situation like this before and wasn't exactly sure how to handle it, meaning, you know, talking about my arm. I wasn't really sure how to react to this, but I kind of just let it go and thought, okay, whatever, we'll see how this goes. We started learning certain skills like how to flush an IV, how to remove an IV, setting up an IV pump, like spiking the bag, priming the tubing, you know, things like that. We have to get checked off on these skills before we can do them in the hospital. So it was my turn to get checked off and I was doing the skill. I don't exactly remember what skill it was. It was probably one of those, but she stopped me in the middle of it and said, you know what, I'll just do this for you. It will just be easier that way. And so she finished the skill and I didn't get to complete it. And I felt kind of embarrassed because I don't really like that she took over for me and thought, you know, like, it'd just be easier if I do it, because I was fully capable of doing that. And I kind of felt like, well, how am I supposed to be a nurse if I have to have other people do my work for me? My classmates even saw how she was treating me and they thought that was totally not fair and that I should definitely go talk to the head of the nursing department about her. At the time, I was a little too scared to go talk to the head of the nursing department about her. So I thought, okay, I'll just kind of see if things get better. All right, so once we actually got to the hospital and we're working with actual patients, one of the things that we all had to do with each of our patients, every clinical, was flush their IV. So all of my classmates got to flush their patient's IV. And when it came time to my patient, my instructor actually grabbed another student and said, I'm gonna have you flush Kelsey's patient's IV. And Kelsey, I want you to watch and explain the procedure. This obviously upset me, and the other student actually kind of like whispered sorry to me because she even knew how unfair this was. I was fully capable of flushing a patient's IV and she just did not trust me to do anything. finally, it was at that point that I was like, all right, I need to go talk to the head of the nursing department because this is not okay. She's taking away opportunities from me, and I'm here to learn and practice. So I went and talked to her. I really didn't feel like it went anywhere. She kind of seemed like she was siding with my instructor, and the only advice she gave me was to just see how it goes. Just keep seeing how it goes, and you know, email me if you have any more concerns. So I felt pretty helpless at this point. I didn't really know how to deal with my instructor, so I just kind of kept going the best I could, but it did continue to get worse. So during our clinical, we have a day where we have to spend the day with a tech and kind of work with them, see what they do. So each of us took our turn. It was finally my turn to work with the tech. Keep in mind, I had already been a CNA at this time, so I knew that I was capable of doing all of the tech work. But at the beginning of the shift, my instructor pulled me to the side and she said, I think it'd be important that you let the tech you're working with know that you only have one hand and the things that you aren't able to do. I honestly couldn't believe she actually said those things to me. I thought for sure by now she would see that I am capable of doing things on my own. So I went with some of my classmates and we talked to the tech about this and we all just kind of laughed about it and thought, you know, she's kind of crazy for thinking these things. Not only was she treating me like I couldn't do anything, she also was just a mean person. Everyone in my clinical group dreaded going to clinicals because of her. I'm pretty sure she made every single one of us cry. She just would yell at all of us and expected so much out of us, and I think she forgot that we are students and that we're learning. Like, this isn't related to my arm, but there was a time when I was passing meds on a patient and she asked me to do a math problem. Now, I've always struggled with math. I even told her, you know, I'm not the best at math. And especially doing math problems in my head, it just takes me a little bit more time to do those problems than most people. So of course she's standing there, you know, saying, what's the answer? So I'm anxious because it's math and because it's her. So I was taking a long time and she yelled at me in front of the patient and said, Kelsey, this is not okay. You cannot be a nurse and be bad at math. So I constantly was scared of going to clinicals because I didn't want to get yelled at her every single day. It seemed like nothing I ever did was good enough for her. And she actually made me question if nursing was for me. There were times when I really just felt like giving up. I'm really glad that I continued on in the nursing program because the rest of my instructors have been nothing but supportive. They've helped me work through how to do certain skills, you know, they've answered any questions I've had, and they just kept encouraging me to keep trying. I even was able to do the skill that I was worried about the most, which was putting in an IV. These instructors never held me back from any opportunities. If my patient needed an IV, then I was the one putting it in. So things did get a lot better for me. My confidence was building back up. I even had a lot of patients say really nice things about me. They told me how impressed they were with how I was able to do everything, and they said I was doing such a good job. One of my patients, actually, she had a stroke and wasn't able to move her right arm. And she told me that seeing me inspired her so much to keep going. And that just really touched me and made me realize that I am meant to be a nurse. My biggest advice for you, if this is something that you are going through with an instructor or a coworker that doesn't think that you're capable of doing something, would be to definitely keep advocating for yourself. That was something that I kind of was afraid to do in the beginning, but it is something that you need to do if you want the help. Keep practicing on your own. Whenever I had free time, I would go to the sim labs and I would practice the nursing skills on my own so that, you know, I could figure out the way that was best for me to do it, and I would show up to clinicals and be able to do it, and I could prove that instructor wrong that I was able to do these skills. And just don't let them get into your head. Remind yourself that you are capable of doing this. You've accomplished so many things in the past, so you can accomplish this. All right, so now I am finishing up the nursing program right now. I'm in my capstone. I'm actually doing that in the ED. I'm doing everything on my own just fine. I'm doing injections, putting IVs in, all kinds of things. It did take me some time to get comfortable with certain skills because I had to figure out the best way for me to do this on my own. So it took a lot of practice, but it definitely paid off because I am comfortable with these skills now. I'm sure there is something that I haven't done yet in clinicals, but I know that I can figure out my own way to do it. Just take some practice and I will eventually be able to do it. Like I said before, I am actually going to be filming a video, you know, in a few weeks now, showing how I do certain nursing skills. In the video, I'm going to demonstrate how I do an IV, how I drop medications, how I flush an IV. So definitely check that out if that's something that you're interested in. Alright, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful for you. If you are a nursing student or you're in, you know, some other program that's similar to this and you are going through a situation like that, leave a comment below and we can kind of talk about it. We can all give each other advice. I think that'd be great. Or if you'd like to privately reach out to me, you can message me on Instagram. It's kelsey.ryan, and I'd be happy to answer any questions or just talk with you if you need to. Be sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more. Thanks. Bye.